स्टूडेंट, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी एनसीईआरटी क्लास 8 पॉलिटिकल साइंस चैप्टर 1 द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ दिस वीडियो. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो व्हाट पॉइंट्स वी हैव टू कवर सच दैट द राइट ऑफ इक्वालिटी, द राइट टू फ्रीडम, राइट अगेंस्ट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन, राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ द रिलीजन, कल्चर एंड द एजुकेशनल राइट, राइट ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल रेमेडीज एंड द सेक्युलरिज्म. In the previous two videos, what you have learned, what the constitution is, why we need the constitution, who is the father of the constitution, why we adopted the constitution, why there is a need of the constitution, how we have to draft the, how the government has drafted the constitution. It's all the things you have learned in this chapter. So let's recall it that like in class 6, in class 7, you heard the word about the constitution, what the constitution is, how the constitution help us, why there is a need of rules and regulation of each and every country. If there is a written constitution, how it help us? If it is a verbal constitution, so how it will help us? It, like, when we made a constitution, of which country we have adopted the constitutional rules, by which we have discussed so much, like our leaders used to sit in the constituent assembly where they discuss, then they made our constitution and they made the article. In the article which we used to call it in Hindi as a Anuchhed, and the constitution which we means the Samvidhan. So earlier we need, why there is a need of constitution, that we have finished. Then we come to know about the minority and the majority. Then we have finished the federalism. Then we finished the separation of the powers. Then we have finished the other points of the what the fundamental rights is. So there are the mainly five points which we have discussed. That is, the first one we have discussed the federalism, second one we have discussed the parliamentary form of government, then we have discussed the separation of power, then we have discussed the fundamental right. So we just only discussed the what the fundamental rights is, which I already said, the fundamental is the important part of the constitution, in which they used to give a certain right that every individual can learn, and from which when we regulate, if like for example, if there is no rule, then take any of the individual, he or she can freely do any work. They don't think whether the particular thing is very much good or whether the particular thing is very much bad. They can do anything. If they are thinking to, if they want to take a revenge from any of the person, so they can shoot them, or they just kill them, or they can do anything, mischief behavior, they can do anything without fearing that there is no rule, nobody can do anything to me, nobody can have a right to do anything to me. If there are the rules, so people have the fear that none of the person can do anything to them. So these are the certain scenario where which can say that the particular thing is done by something or some. Let's start with the right to equality. You have read in the class 7th in the political science about the equality. Irrespective of your place of birth, irrespective of your what state you belong to, irrespective of your religion, irrespective of your caste, irrespective of your creed, the different scenario you have seen, where whether you belong from the upper class, whether you belong from the lower caste, whether you are rich or poor, we are all equal. This is the key feature of our constitution, and I'm including that word also, why India is considered as the very good country, where disparity of, despite of diverse in a country, we all are equal. That there is one quote we have, unity in diversity, the diverse region we have, the diversity we have, different culture we have, different language we have, different dress sense they have, still we are all equal. Equality in the sense that people have a right of equality. We can't discriminate between the whether someone is rich or someone is poor, someone is literate or someone is illiterate, someone is belong from the upper caste, someone is belong from the lower caste. Irrespective of everything, the people are equal. Now we talk about right to freedom. Yes, this is also one of the important part, is that the people, is the freedom, they can express their views, they can express their thinking, wherever they go, they can can speak anything, but that doesn't mean they can speak the abusive language. They can speak anything, they can express their views, they can express their thought, by which they come to know that what thing I did or what thing I didn't did. So these are the certain scenario which we can say that the people of India used to get the freedom. First we can see what they has written in the textbook. First we can see the right to equality. All the person are equal before the law. In the front of law starts from the president of Kanta, all are equal. This means that all the people shall be equally protected by the law of the country. Means equally, whether it's rich or poor, upper caste or the lower caste, or you can say the literate or illiterate, any of the person starting from the first citizen, that is the president till the Kanda, each and every person is equally treated in front of the law. Then it also said that the no citizen can be discriminated against on the basis of the religion, which I've already discussed, the caste, sex. Every person has access to all the public places. They can go in any of the public places, hotels, shop, playgrounds, including the numerous of the things. The state cannot discriminate against anyone in the matter of employment. Yes, that is true. None of the state government have the right, or it didn't have the right to you can say abide or the discriminate on the basis of the employment. But there are the exceptions to this that you will read about later in this book. Number of the things are that you will later on read that the practice of untouching has also been completely abolished, which we have discussed many a times in the previous class in 6. We discussed in 7th standard the untouchability is completely abolished after the independence, because before the independence, the number of the people of the India, they were discriminated on the basis of that this people is belong from the lower caste. If they used to touch us and if they come in front of us or they come to nearby us, the shadow, or they used to touch us, then we become impure. For purity purpose, we have to do the certain rituals, that we have to go towards the pandit, or you can say the priest. Then he used to do the certain practices, and by which then we have to take a bath in the Ganga, then we will become the completely pure. So by that, the untouchability is completely abolished. Why they used to completely abolish? Because the earlier the people of the lower caste, they do not allowed to sit together with the upper class people. They don't allow to go to the school. They don't allow to go to the temples. They don't allow to go to the different society. So these are the things where we can say that these people do not get the access, or these people do not get the dignity. These people do not get the, you can say, the different kinds of things where we can say that they do not get the correct or the different forms of, you can say, a kind of a respect if they want, we didn't give them. So these are the things which we can say that irrespective of place of birth, state, religion, caste, male and female, rich or poor, or you can say the literate or illiterate, all the people are equal. It starts, which I, again and again I'm giving the example, starts from first citizen of India, that is from president to till the Kanta. Now come towards the second, the right to freedom. That it is, this includes the right of freedom of speech, expression, the right to form of association, the right to move freely and reside in any part of the country, and the right to practice any of the profession, occupation and business. In a country, we can move anywhere. We do not have any kind of barriers that one of the state used to stop us. We can go anywhere or any of the places. We can go in any of the state. We can go any of the public places. We have the freedom of speech, freedom of expression. We have a right, or we have given the right. We can choose any of the education which we want. We can choose any of the occupation or employment which we want to choose. We are free in all the terms. But that doesn't mean we have to use this right as a, in the misbehave, or you can say you to use the abusive language. We can't use that. You have to keep this thing in mind that a certain right is given to us. So we have to use this moral values. We have to use this particular behavior which we used to change us. Now come to the next, that is the right against the exploitation. The constitution prohibits the human trafficking, forced labor, children working under the age of 14 years. Now we're talking about what the human trafficking is. Human trafficking usko kaha jata hai jo humans ko becha jata hai, aur jisko kaha jata hai kharid firot. Means from like particular one country, you are selling the person to the another country, like this this type of human trafficking is completely illegal. Before the independence, you can say, or in the ancient time, nowadays also the human trafficking is going over there. In the some part of the country, like the there are the few countries where human trafficking are still going on, but it is completely illegal, and it is said that we have right against the exploited. None of the exploitation is against over there. Now, if we talk about the child labor. The children till the age of the 14, we do not have a right to employ any of the child who is below the age of 14. So they have given the certain rights that this child have to go for the education. We do not have a right to employ any of the small children. Any child labor, हम किसी छोटे बच्चे को job नहीं देख सकते. उनका क्या right है? उनको education provide करना, उनके बचपन को चीनी देना. तो ये है child labor पे हमने बात की, human trafficking की. तो the next example is of forced labor. If you ask me what the forced labor is, there are the certain you can say leader or a group where they used to force the labor to you do this kind of work. Means कुछ ऐसे कह सकते हैं हम लोग माफिया को या लीडर्स को जो लेबर्स को उनका बिना चाहे उनके फोर्सफुली उनसे काम करवाते हैं. जैसे मान लो उनसे 12 आवर्स 14 आवर्स काम करवाते हैं, फिर उनको खाने के लिए नहीं देते, उनको पैसे नहीं देते, उनको वेजेस प्रोवाइड नहीं करते. तो इतनी सारी चीजें होती है जैसे उनको बहुत ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम होती है और उनको बहुत सारी चीजें दखल अंदाजी उनको देखना पड़ता है. तो ये सारी चीजें जो उनको देखना पड़ता है कि क्या हमें इस चीज को, यही सारी चीजें राइट अगेंस्ट एक्सप्लॉयटेशन में आती है. फर्स्ट थिंग इज वी हैव टू स्टॉप द ह्यूमन ट्रैफिकिंग. वी डू नॉट एम्प्लॉयड और वी डू नॉट गिव द जॉब्स टू द लेबरर्स, द चाइल्ड लेबरर्स. वी डू नॉट हैव टू give the employment to that people who do not want to do the work, or we do not have to take lots of work from the labor, that the forced labor. We ye nahi ki bina kisi ke chahe usko utha ke le aaye usko kaam karwa rahe. To ye sare examples aate hain right against the exploitation. Now we talk about the next, that is the right to freedom of religion. Yes, whatever the religion you have, you can opt what religion you want to. If you're going by the definition, what the definition states that that the religious freedom is provided to all the citizen. Every person has the right to practice, profess and propagate the religion of their choice. Means यहाँ पे हर इंसान को वो freedom दिया गया है, वो अपनी इच्छा से अपने धर्म को choose कर सकता है, उसके practice कर सकता है, उसको ritual को profess को use कर सकता है, और उसको किसी भी तरह की रोक टोक नहीं है. whether you are Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, Buddhist, Zoroastrian, Jainism, whatever the religion you have, you can practice it. Nobody has a right to stop you. You in India, that we are very lucky that any of the religion we can practice it. Nobody can stop us. If I used to like some any other religion, if I want to change my religion, I can change it. Not like our country is not like the other countries where, like if you talk about the Islamic country or you can talk about the Mohammedan countries where they practicing the Islam, but if the Hindu was reside over there, so they do not come in front of the people, they do not do the practice, certain kind of practice. They used to do the practice at their home only. Means what I try to say is कि कुछ ऐसी मुस्लिम्स कंट्री हैं जहाँ पे मुस्लिम्स का सारे धर्म वगैरह की प्रैक्टिसेस चलती है, वहाँ पे जो हिंदूस रहते हैं वो सामने आकर प्रैक्टिस नहीं करते, पर उनको ये हक दिया जाता है कि आप अपने घर में कर सकते हो, सामने नहीं. अगर हम अपने इंडिया की बात करें तो इंडिया में सारे धर्म के प्रैक्टिस किए जाते हैं, चाहे वो हिंदू हो, मुस्लिम हो, सिख हो, क्रिश्चियनिटी हो, जैनिज्म हो, बुद्धिज्म हो, ज़ोरास्ट्रियन हो, एनी ऑफ द रिलीजन वी कैन प्रैक्टिस इन इंडिया. No one can stop us. We have the right, what the rituals we have to perform, what the profess we have to do, each and everybody is allowed over here. So you can do any kind of work. Now we talk about right, culture and the educational right. The constitution states that all the minority religious and linguistics can set up their own educational institution in order to preserve and develop their own culture. Now what is the interesting thing is over there, right of the freedom of the culture and the educational rights. Here in our constitution, they give the right to each and every religion and the culture. They can set up their own school by which the people, the particular people of the particular culture and religion, they can learn what their culture is, what their religion is.
हमारे इंडिया में हर रिलीजन और कल्चर को ये हक दिया गया है कि अपना खुद का इंस्टीट्यूशन वो सेटअप कर सकते हैं, जिससे वो उनके धर्म के बारे में जाने, जिससे वो उनके कल्चर के बारे में जाने कि उनका धर्म क्या है, किस चीज का है, तो उस चीज को भी प्रैक्टिस करने का हक दिया गया। सो दिस काइंड ऑफ समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग लाइक हाउ द आर इंडिया सच सच अ डाइवर्स कंट्री दैट वी आर गिविंग द रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी रिलीजन, ईच एंड एवरी कल्चर, वेयर दे कैन सेट अप देयर ओन इंस्टीट्यूशन, वी कैन लर्न फ्रॉम दिस। इफ आई वी टॉक अबाउट द फोर्थ एंड द फिफ्थ राइट, लाइक if I talk about me, I like to go everywhere. I used to go in the temples, I used to go in the gurudwaras, I used to go in the churches, I used to go in the, you can say the mosque, I used to go in the Jain temples, I used to go in Buddhist. No one has stopped me till now. I used to go in every places. So I used to learn the different religions, what the different practice they're doing, what kind of the god they have, what are the dressing sense they have, what are the culture have there. Such a diverse country we have, we can learn numerous of things, whether it's from, you can learn from the Hinduism, whether you can learn from the Islam, you can learn from the Christianity, you can learn from the Sikh, you can learn from the Jainism, you can learn from the Buddhism. So there are the numbers of things you can learn from the different people, from the different culture. Likewise, it can expand our knowledge, it can expand our horizon, what the diverse culture we have, what the diverse religion we have, from which we can learn numerous of things. So these are the particular thing, the culture and the educational right. Now we talk about the sixth right of the constitution remedy. Means there are the certain remedies which we have to do it like that. This allows the citizen to move the court if they believe that any of their fundamental rights have been violated by the state. If from this six fundamental rights, if any of the fundamental rights is violated, so we have given that right, we can file the case in the court against the particular people or the particular community or in the particular individual or maybe against the state and the center as well. यानी अगर हमें लगता है कि कोई भी हमारे fundamental rights को violate, यानी उसको तोड़ा गया है, उसको हानि पहुंचाई गई है, तो उसके खिलाफ कोर्ट में केस कर सकते हैं और वो इंसान, वो पर्टिकुलर इंसान को उसको अबाइड किया जाता है कि हाँ ये उसके, ऐसे बहुत सारे केसेस है जो आप इस आगे के चैप्टर्स में इसमें पढ़ोगे कि किसने किसके साथ केस किया, क्यों का, स्टेट वर्सेस समथिंग दैट, स्टेट वर्सेस द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट वर्सेस स्टेट एंड सम पर्टिकुलर पर्सन वर्सेस द अदर स्टेट। तो दिस आर द सर्टेन सिनेरियो व्हिच यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस बुक, like how this fundamental right should not be violated. If you think that your right is violated, you have the right, you can go in the court and file a case against these people. So these are the certain things which we have discussed in this 5 and 6 point about the fundamental rights. Which fundamental right will be following situation violated? I mean, like we would like to discuss this. If a 13-year-old child is working in the factory manufacturing garment, so here the right is violated. If we talk about the next, if a politician is the one state decide to not allow the laborers from the other state to work in their state, the politician one state decide to not allow the laborers, and if the one state is decide you do not go in the another state, so this is the again the right of the freedom of the rights which is violated, or here it is come the right against the exploitation in the second one. If we talk about the third, if a group of people are not given the permission to open the Telugu medium school in Kerala, so this right will come under this, the right culture and the educational right. And the last one, if the government decide not to promote an officer of the armed force of being a woman, so that used to come in the right to freedom, irrespective of whether it's a boy or girl. If he or she is doing very good work, so the particular occupation or particular occupation leader have the duty to promote the particular girl on whichever the field is there, whether it's the armed forces is there, whether it's a civil service is there, whether it's a normal, I'm using the word normal, what type the profession, whatever the occupation they have, whether it's a girl or boy, they have to promote them, because this is our right that we have to do the justice. Now come to the last point of this chapter, that is the secularism. What the secularism means, a secular state is the one in which the state does not officially promote any one religion as a state religion. We will read more the following in this chapter. The secular means none of the state have a right to promote a particular religion, matlab kisi bhi state ke paas ऐसा कोई हक या राइट नहीं दिया गया कि वो पर्टिकुलर एक धर्म को प्रमोट करे, कि जैसे कि मान लो फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी टेक दी यूपी, सो यूपी जस्ट प्रमोट दी हिंदुइज्म और मुस्लिम, यानी पर्टिकुलर धर्म को लेकर के हमारे हिंदू इस धर्म चलेगा और कोई धर्म नहीं चलेगा, ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं है. नन ऑफ द स्टेट हैज अ राइट टू प्रमोट दी रिलीजन, दे ऑल द रिलीजन इरिस्पेक्टिव कम, इफ यू सी फ्रॉम द नेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, ऑब्वियसली द स्टेट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, ऑल द रिलीजन इज ट्रीटेड एज इक्वल, नॉट मोर देन नॉट अ लेसर देन. नाउ वी कम टू अस, यू नाउ अंडरस्टैंड द वेज इन विच द कंट्री हिस्ट्री ऑफन डिटरमाइन द काइंड ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दैट अ कंट्री अडॉप्ट्स ऑफ इटसेल्फ. द कंट्री द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्ले अ क्रूशियल रोल इन लेइंग आउट द आइडियाज दैट वी वुड लाइक ऑल द सिटीजन ऑफ कंट्री टू अडहेयर टू, इंक्लूडिंग द रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स दैट वी इलेक्ट टू रूल अस. जस्ट लाइक इन द गेम ऑफ फुटबॉल, अ चेंज ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिव रूल्स विच वी अफेक्ट द गेम्स, लाइक विच वी हैव डिस्कस इन द फर्स्ट वीडियो दैट if the any of the game where there is no rule, so the game is become like a kind of a injustice. Why I'm using the word injustice, because if you are playing a game, whether you win or lose, nobody can justify it, nobody can say whether other team is win or other team is losing, so there is a need of a rules. So in the constitution also, for the country also, the country need a rule or law by which the people have a certain kind of idea and certain kind of perception in the back of their mind they have, that they do not have to do a wrong word or wrong word or wrong deeds or wrong, you can say, a particular crime they do not have to do. Why? Because if they commit any of the crimes, so they have the certain fear that I committed this crime, so the law will punish me, the government, or you can say the judiciary will punish me. So they do not do any kind of crime, they can do only the good work. So these are the certain scenario which we have seen in there, that this type of work is done by them and this type of work is done by them. So in this kind of scenario we can see that in if agar jaise koi game hai jo bina rules aur regulations ke nahi chal sakta, isi tarah se jo bhi desh hai wo bhi bina rules aur regulations ke nahi chal sakta, usme hame rules aur regulations chahiye. Now we talk about more further. India Constitution has been changed over the years to reflect the new concerns of the polity. Yes, Constitution में जैसे मैंने आपको first video में ही बताया था कि हम Constitution में जो हमारे articles हैं उसको हम completely हटा नहीं सकते पर change कर सकते हैं. तो ये कई कई बार किया गया है over the period of time. Often a major change in the Constitution means the change in the fundamental nature of the country. अगर हम पूरे Constitution को change करेंगे तो fundamental को change करना पड़ेगा. But हमारे Constitution में ऐसा पहले से ही रूल दिया गया है, एक आर्टिकल में लिखा गया, हम कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन कंप्लीटली हटा नहीं सकते या खत्म नहीं कर सकते. हाँ, ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम जब टाइम्स चेंजेस होते हैं, फिर कुछ कुछ नए नए रिफॉर्म्स होती है, रेवोल्यूशन होता है, तो उसको हमें चेंज करना पड़ता है, क्योंकि वक्त के साथ चेंज होना बहुत जरूरी है. वी हैव टू चेंज आवर सेल्फ अकॉर्डिंग टू टाइम, व्हाट आर द टाइम वी हैव, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सिनेरियो वी हैव टू चेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट. इफ यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू चेंज दैट इज गोइंग टू रून अस. We saw in this case that Nepal how it needs to adopt a new constitution, which changes. First they adopted in 1990, then it used to change in 2006. Then in 2007 they are using the interim constitution. After that, after so many years, they got their new constitution. So think about it, how many times you have to change, how many changes you have to do, how much discussion you have to do. It takes lots of time, it takes lots of ideas of the different peoples, like what the idea they have. And you have to think about each and every individual, okay, he or she used to treat it equally. We can't treat it like someone is inferior, someone is superior. So we have to treat all the individual as equal. We can't treat them as a inferior, superior, because we have to keep this in mind. The right to equality, right to freedom has a right of each and every individual, of not only in India. I thought in every places, in every place, in every country on this globe. But if we talk about our India, so this is the two utmost ones, and that is equality and freedom. This is the right of each and every individual. Now come towards the this the Indian features of the Indian constitution outline above involve complicated ideas that are often not easy to grasp. Don't worry too much about this for this moment. In the rest of the book, as well as the higher classes, you have read about the constitution. Yes, this is true. In the previous video, in the first video, I've already said that, like in the higher classes, you will learn about the different countries, how the constitution they have, how they adopted, how much they fight to want their democratic country, to want their constitution, and how they have to change the law. Like in the monarchical government, in the monarchical, I'm using the word government, because in the monarchical type of government, they have to exploit too much. But in the democratic kind of government, they do not have to exploit that much. They have the freedom to express their views, to express their ideas, to express their, you can say the expression, what they want to do. That doesn't mean the, you can say the abusive word or the behavior which we not qualified or which we are not accepting it. That kind of behavior we can't accept it. We have to do that kind of work only which we accept it. You can see this pictures with the Jawaharlal Nehru is signing on the when the constitution is made. You can see this, the above photo shows the various members signing the copy of constitution at his final session. The first from the top, Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru signing. The second photo is Dr. Rajendra Prasad, President of the Constitutional Assembly, which I already said, the President and the Prime Minister and the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. These are the three people who are the like seated over there. The last photo shows the following person from the right to left, that is Sri Jairam Das Daulatara, Minister of Food and Agriculture, Ajay Rajkumar Amritkar, that is Health Minister, Dr. John Mehta, the Finance Minister, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Deputy Prime Minister, and the behind him, the Sri Jagjivan Ram, the Labour Minister. So these are the minister when the final constitution made on 26 November 1949. All the people are signing out that this is the final constitution. You can see our constitution first page, that is the preamble. You can see in your textbook, which is I think in each and every NCERT books, there is the preamble page. I think it's not in this textbook, that is not there. But if you see any of your textbook, there is the first page which is written of the fundamental rights, and preamble is written over there. Maybe you can see in your science or the maths textbook, there is one page that is written over the preamble or the fundamental rights of the India, that is mentioned over there. If you want to see in the particular, you can see on the net also how our constitution is. If you visit any of the museum, you can see how our constitution is. If you want to see the real constitution, that is in the Delhi, where you can find it, the real constitution is put in the one glass box where you can see the real our constitution is. It is very much in big, it is in detailed form, that we can see the how the people are you doing this work. Like you can think about it, we are very lucky that we are living in India, and the constitution is very much detailed and it is very much good, where each and every people is treated equally. They have a freedom of speech, freedom of education. They can opt any of the education what they want to. They can opt any of the occupation or the employment which they want to. They can go anywhere they want, where they want to, where they want to go. That there are not a barriers that certain people can stop you. So you can go, you can do anything whatsoever you can want to. But but back of the mind, we have to keep this idea that whatever the rights have they are mentioned, we have to keep this in mind. What I'm trying to say is, जो हमारे constitution में rules लिखे हुए, regulations लिखे हुए, उसको ध्यान में रखकर हम कुछ भी कर सकते हैं. जैसे कि हम freedom of speech दी गई है, हमें freedom of expression दिया गया है, freedom of expression of views दिया गया है. हम कोई भी education को opt कर सकते हैं, हम कोई भी employment या occupation को choose कर सकते हैं, जिससे हमें किसी भी तरह की कोई problem ना हो, कोई भी हमें ना रोक सके. तो ये सारी चीजें हमने देखी कि राइट टू इक्वालिटी क्या होता है, राइट टू फ्रीडम क्या होता है, राइट अगेंस्ट द एक्सप्लॉयटेशन क्या होता है, राइट टू फ्रीडम ऑफ रिलीजन क्या होता है, कल्चर एंड एजुकेशनल राइट क्या होता है, राइट ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन रेमेडीज क्या होता है, सेक्युलरिज्म क्या होता है. ये सारी चीजें हमने देखी कि व्हाई वी नीड द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, व्हाट इज डू यू मीन बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, हु इज द फादर ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. Then we discuss the different key features of the separation of the powers, parliamentary form of government, then federalism, then we talk about the fundamental rights. And these are the fundamental rights we have discussed: right to equality, right to freedom, right against the exploitation, right to freedom of religion, culture, and the educational right. Then we discuss about the right to the constitution remedies and the secularism, that we are very much lucky that we are the citizen of the India. We have to get that much amount of equality. We have we are learning the diverse region of our country. We are learning the diverse in the region. I'm using the word region means the area. हम लोग उससे बहुत सारी चीजें सीखे, अगर different state है, हर किसी का खुद का culture है, खुद का dance form है, खुद की languages है, खुद का dressing form है, उससे हम बहुत सारी चीजें सीख रहे हैं. If we talk about particular India, हमारे India में ही कितनी सारी languages बोली जाती है. अगर आप 7th class को recall करें तो उसमें दिया गया है more than 1600 languages we are speaking. And the majorly if we talk about the religion, there are the 8 major religion which we are practicing. But there are lots of religion in India, still we are practicing. Each and every religion have a right. They can open their institution by which the people of their community or people of their religion, they can learn what their religion they have and what kind of culture they have. So each and every religion have a right that they can do what they want to, but in the good way, not in the bad way. So this is the chapter what our Indian constitution is. It is very in detail. It is in the written form. It is the or the world ka sabse bada constitution mana, that is in the detail form. So these are the, I hope you like this video. This was the things which we have discussed in this chapter. Thank you.